The advice I would give to an up-and-coming business leader is to obviously pay attention to your bottom line, care about profits and efficiency, but always allow for a little bit of chaos and experimentation.
We try to be transparent so that we're talking continuously with them about their needs, that there are no surprises for them, and that when maybe we are not on the same page, we find out about it very early on in the process.
Be certain that your books are in order and your chart of accounts properly reflects your business processes and how you make money. Is your business growing? Is it profitable? Or has it run into some headwind?
The advice I would give to up-and-coming female business leaders is be passionate and crystal clear about your goals. Before making a big decision, sleep on it.
We've really embedded philanthropy into the company culture, so while my employees work like crazy, they're all involved in personal philanthropic projects. It's not just about making money.
We've integrated philanthropy in many different ways. In fact, just recently we donated 2 vans to take underprivileged women for mammographies, people that otherwise couldn't get there on their own.
You know, I really admire Howard Schultz. I just think it is incredible how he's built Starbucks into really a community center around the world. And so I think his insight that it was so much more than coffee is really, truly brilliant.
One CEO who I really admire is Angela Ahrendts. She was the CEO of Burberry, and during her tenure there, I believe it was 7 years, she, I think, tripled the revenues of the company, and this was in the billions. She's just doing a phenomenal job, and I'm so impressed with everything she's done.
My favorite CEO, and the one that I learned the most from, was my father. We worked out every issue, every problem, anything that was going on in my business. He actually is the one that inspired me to do this 18 years ago. He always said the right thing at the right time with compassion.
As nonprofit leaders,
we've seen firsthand
that when the right mission
meets the right inspiration,
we can change the world.
Future leaders should recognize that early in their career, they're learning skills with each new job that they have, and they should put those skills away in their toolbox to use when they become a leader.
So this is a complex world and it's a changing world. Each of us has to ultimately take with us our own reputation. And so no matter what we do, we as individuals have to stand behind it.
To be a great leader, you must feel comfortable being different. And then sometimes there are really tough decisions, but as a leader, I absolutely feel that you have to believe in the decisions that you make and back them and be okay not being popular or being different.
I love helping people become the best that they can be. I have a program that I call Setting Your GPS, and I travel campuses and I teach girls how to network, how to advocate for themselves, and how to be the very, very best that they can be.
I get to speak at a lot of funerals, and what I understand now is that we really help people leave this world with love and dignity and laughter. So the fact that I get to help families experience one last moment of joy really makes all of this worth it.